guys! In today's video, we'll show you some DIY present ideas to give to your family and friends at any special occasion. They are all really easy to personalize and I hope they can inspire you, so let's start! To make your own clay accessories, you will need some cornstarch, white glue, Vaseline, oil, and some acrylic paint or nail polish. The first thing I wanted to make was a dust plat, so I took some broken headphones and removed the rubber part. I also cut the tip. This took me a while, so I recommend buying some plastic plugs if you can. To make the clay, mix a teaspoon and a half of cornstarch with a teaspoon and a half of white glue. A tiny bit of Vaseline and a tiny bit of oil. Mix it well until it has a sticky texture. Put it on a pot with hot water and heat it until it thickens and completely sticks to the spoon. Now it's time to create any shape you want. I decided to make a bear, so I made a big ball and then cut a smaller one in half to make the ears. Then I made a hole to glue the plug later. I also made a cut by making a ball and pinching the top part to make the ears. In this case, I made a little hook with some wire to hang it later. Then let them dry for 3 days. Once they are hard, it's time to paint them. You can use acrylic paint or nail polish. I painted one of the bears like Gorilla Kuma. The other one I painted it like a cute panda. And I painted a cute face to the cat. Finish them with some top coat. I made 3 different accessories. The first bear, I attach it to a keychain. Then I put my plug on my phone, add a tiny bit of glue to the top, and attach the panda to make a dust plug. And for the cat, I attach it to a long chain to make a necklace. There are tons of different accessories you can make with this clay, so it's the easiest gift to personalize. For the second idea, you will need some cardboard, some cardstock, 2 book rings, pictures, and scrapbook supplies. To make this mini album, you will need to cut 2 squares of cardboard to make the covers, and some cardstock squares of the same size for the pages. First, make some holes, making sure that each page has the holes at the same place. For this, use the first page as a guide. You can decorate the cover however you want. I, for example, stick a piece of silver wrapping paper. Then I use some transferable letters for the title, but you can print them too. And finally, I glue some scrapbook flowers and rhinestone stickers. For the inside, I just stick my pictures and decorate them with some washi tape. Finally, I just place the rings and that's it. This gift is super personal and also really easy to personalize. next one is an edible gift, and it's really easy to make. Do we need dark chocolate, white chocolate, some pistachios, raisins, and walnuts. The first step is melting your chocolate. Put in a pot with hot water and a glass with your chocolate inside. Once it's melted, put it onto some foil or some wax paper and spread it until you have an even layer. Melt the white chocolate too and mix it with the dark chocolate as I'm doing here to create a marble effect. Then place your dry fruits and nuts. I chose pistachios, raisins, and walnuts, but you can use any dry fruits and nuts you want. Push them a little bit with a spoon and let it set in the fridge for 30 minutes. Then you can break it and place it in a jar. And I decided to decorate the jar with a little tag and a bow. Super easy, it looks really nice, and the best part, it tastes awesome. The last idea is a really cute little detail, and you will need some tea lights, washi tape, ribbon, and cellophane wrap. First, line the little candles with your washi tape, as I'm doing here. Stack them and wrap them in cellophane. Finally, I made a bow for decoration. I know this gift is not a big thing, but I think it's the perfect stocking stuffer and it's a beautiful way to give candles without spending a lot of money. So I hope you like these little gift ideas, I hope they could inspire you, and remember that giving presents is not about buying something super expensive, but about taking time to think about the other person and giving them something personal and meaningful. Thanks for watching, bye!